isso mesmo.
Ok?
Let's start again now. We will start our topic today. Today we are talking, guys, please focus. Today we are talking about some modifying units and rep. Like if you have words and you want to trim, extend, copy, move, blah, blah, blah. We will talk about this topic now. If you have some words in your skill, like these words, we will create some random words and work on them. Fine? Once you select any object in Revit, it will automatically drive you and takes you to modify the object that you are selecting. Fine? So since I'm selecting a word, it's modify words. If I'm selecting windows, doors, and so on, it's like modifying for that selected object. Fine? Now, if you look on the modify panel, you will have some modifying tools, a little bit similar to the AutoCAD modifying tools. Let's go deep and see what are these tools. The first one, I will start from move. The first one is move. If you are going to move any object, either you select the object and you just click on it and drag, so you are moving it randomly. Okay? This way, and this method does not give you the ability to get some snaps or to give an exact distance to move. Fine? So you are just clicking on the selected object and moving it. Fine, randomly. If this is the case, just use this tool. If not, and you are looking for a snapping base point, or you are looking to give an exact distance for this tool, so just click on modify, move, or the shortcut is MV. Fine? So go for move, click on it. Now you can click on any of the objects, snapping options. Fine? Maybe you need the endpoint. Just click on the endpoint, and now you can move it. And if you want to provide some distances or an exact distance, just click it, go to the orientation you want, and then just click, for example, 5 meters, and enter. Fine? Again, click on the object, click on move, click on the base point that you are moving from, the direction, and if you look on the screen, you will have the dimension, right, or the distance. Just input like 4 meters and click enter. It's just similar to the AutoCAD. Fine? It's the moving tool. And just remember, if you click any tool in Revit, you will have this ribbon available. It will ask you, do you want to constrain a constraint for your movement? It's like the orthographic in AutoCAD, vertical and horizontal, but it's a little bit special. Just click on constraint. If you click on this object, it will move vertical or horizontal. Okay? Sometimes 45 degrees. Fine? And if you need a distance, just input your distance. Another thing, if you have 2 joined walls, for example, and you move this wall, it will also extend this wall to match that movement. Fine? Sometimes you don't want to extend this wall also, so you just click MV or move, and just click on this join. Once you move your wall, it will be moved without extending this wall with that movement. Fine? So just keep looking on this ribbon because it's very important while working on it. You will find many options for many objects that you are moving or copying or whatsoever. Fine? Okay, the other tool or the second tool is copy. It's just like AutoCAD also. CO, the shortcut. Just click on copy and now you can copy this object from this point to this point. And also you can provide a distance. CO, you can click here, go to the direction that you want, input 1.2 for example. It will copy the object for 1.2 away from your object. Fine? Once you click on copy, you will have some options also here. You can click on constrain, I think, and it will do the same like orthographic. And you can make a multiple copy. If you are copying for more than once, so you need to check this option. and then you can copy more than one object. If you don't check this option, you will just have the ability to copy this object for one time only, and then you need to do the order again, CO and click and click, CO again, click and fine. So if you are copying more than once, you have to check this option.
Multiple copy with the same distance.
It's an array.
It's like
we will talk about array. Mm-hmm. Fine? Okay, it's another question. Thank you. Let's select it again. The third object is rotate. And the rotation here is also similar to the AutoCAD. Just click on RO for rotation, or on the tool, on the modify panel. Now you will automatically have the base point in the center of the selection. Let's keep it in the center now. You have to click the base point of the angle, the start point of the rotation process, and then you can move your mouse to the direction that you are rotating your object to. Now you can input the angle, or you can just click wherever you want. Maybe you need to rotate it for 45 degrees. Just click 45 degrees and click enter. You will have the rotation. Why? For example, let's move it here. And maybe we have this wall also. Fine. And I want this wall to be rotated from the base point, from this point to this point. You can do it, just rotate, keep the base point in the center, click on the first point and just move to click on the second point. It will be rotated to that. So you have more than one option. You can rotate it using a value, or you can rotate it using a reference point. Fine? The most important thing in AutoCAD when you are rotating anything is the base point, right?
Yes.
Perfect. So how can I change the base point by rotating in Revit? Let's do it together. RO, you have this point automatically. I told you to look always where?
On
the ribbon. Now you have this option, center of rotation, and you have the button place. If you click on place, or the space on the keyboard, the shortcut for this option is the space on the keyboard. If you click on this option, now it's a free. It asks you now to select where is your best point of rotation. Just click on this option, or sorry, this point for example. Now you need to click on the first point of the angle and the other point or the value of the angle. Just click here, then rotate as much as you need. Fine? So you can either to keep your center point in the center of the selection, or to change it as you need. The third tool, or the fourth tool, let's go for align and offset. It's also a little bit similar to AutoCAD. If you are aligning a wall, for example, I want this wall from this edge to be aligned to this wall on this edge. Why? So it will remain in its place and it will change its orientation. Why? Go to align or AL. Just click on the line that you want it to remain in its place and you are aligning on. Again, AL. Click on this line, it will remain in its place, and just keep sure, or make sure, sorry, that you have this hidden line. This hidden line means that you are aligning on this line. Click on this edge of the wall, it will align this edge to that edge. And now they are perpendicular. Why? Again, I am aligning, for example, this edge on this edge. I will click on align. Then I will click on this edge, then on one of these edges. It's not selecting, but it's perfectly perpendicular. Just click align, this one, then this one. Fine. This is the aligning tool, and you can use it either on the wall or any other object on it. All these walls work on all the objects on it. Let's go for the other tool, which is offset. What does offset do in AutoCAD? It always copies for a certain distance, and it will always be parallel. And you don't need to draw the path or the value of it, right? Just click on offset, or select any object. You can do it. Click on offset. I want to offset this one. Before you offset this one, You need to add a value. You need to add what value, right? Just insert your value here on there. And just notice that I'm always saying that you find the option on the ribbon. You have to go to the ribbon. You have to see the ribbon. You will always deal with this ribbon. It's like the command bar in Africa. So I want to make the offset distance like 3 meters, for example. Fine? And then I will click on the object that I'm using the tool for on the side of the direction. So this is the center line of the wall. If I'm clicking on this side, notice that hidden line appears. It will offset this direction. This will offset here to that direction. Fine? So always you click on the bar of the object, which is towards the offset direction. Fine? And you always insert your value here on there. If you want to erase the source file while offset, you need to check this box, this copy option. Just click on it. Now, if you offset this wall, it will delete the source. It's like the movement 3 meters towards the direction. Fine? You need to write? Okay. So now we know the move, copy, rotate, align, and offset. Sometimes you need to trim or extend your objects. In AutoCAD, you have two separate tools, one for trim and one for extend. Now in Revit, we have the same tool for both. But the case that you are extending or trimming with a corner, or you will keep it open. Let's see how. If you have this wall, for example, this wall and that wall, fine? And I want to extend this wall towards the extension of this one without connecting these two walls together. And I will keep it open here. Fine, let's see how. Click on this tool, which is trim and extend. Then click on the tool that you want to use as a reference this time. Then click on the object that you are extending. So we'll extend to the extension of this edge. In AutoCAD, the two lines should be intersecting after the extend, right? If they don't intersect, it will not be extended. Here no, it will extend your objects towards the extension of the elements. Fine? Also the trim. Let's say that you have this wall like this, for example. Fine? And I want it to meet the extension of this wall. Just click again on this tool, which is trim or extend, and click on the edge, then click on the part that you want it to remain in your drawing. Fine? That's the trim and extend. Now in Revit, you have two tools for the same purpose, this one and this one. Trim and extend. One for single selection, and the other for multiple selections. For example, you want to extend all of these walls to match the extension of this wall. You can click on this point, click here, then you can have this window selection. Fine? Did you notice that, Ronald? Did you notice that? Fine. Again, now you have all these walls and you want them all to intersect with this one. You can click on this tool, which is multiple trim or extend. Click on the tool or the edge of the wall. Then click here. Then make a window selection. Fine. This tool does not allow you to make a window selection. You should click on single objects only. Fine, guys? You understand? Perfect. Okay. The other tool is trim and extend with a corner. This wall does not intersect with this wall if I extend one of them, right? So if I want the corner to be connected, I will use this one, trim and extend also, but with a corner. Click here, click on this object, then on this object, will select the corner. Fine, again, this object and then this object will connect it to it. Fine? So these are the modifying option and the most important one. We also need one more option, which is the mirror. What does the mirror do? as well reflect the object on an axis that you are selecting or an axis you are drawing. Then you have that what you have in Revit. You have two tools for the mirror, one for picking an axis and the other for drawing an axis. Click on the drawing an axis, click on this object and this object, for example, together using the control key. I will click on this one. Sorry, again. Let's draw a detail map, for example. Okay. If you select this tool, it's a pick axis. And this tool is a draw axis. I will select the object, mirror, then I will draw an axis for the mirror. It will reflect it on the other side of the axis that we are drawing. Fine. If you click on this tool, let's select our objects. Click on this tool and pick this axis. It will reflect it using this person. Fine. So that are the modifying tools that you are using. And now, draw the first wall. This is the tool, architecture.
So
wall.
What is the mirror? What is the difference between this?
I will tell you now. Give me 1 second. Architecture, wall, you can draw. Fine, guys. Then, please, I want you to do the same for 5 options. Copy, move, level. Our friend is asking, what are the differences between the mirror picking an axis and mirror drawing an axis? The first one, you should have something, an object in your drawing. Like I'm selecting this one, I want to use mirror, pick an axis. I need to select an axis like this one, maybe this one, maybe this one.
Existing one.
It's, yes, it's an object in the viewport and I can use an axis, and sorry, as an axis for the mirror. I select this one, mirror, then I can select this. Fine. I select this one and I click on mirror, draw an axis. I should draw an axis just like in AutoCAD. From this point, it will be mirror. Fine. Is it okay, guys? Fine. Now you can do that on your system, please.